welcome everyone. This is Fabio from BizLogic, and today is our third fun and work day. I'm currently on my way to the office, and I'm super excited because today we have some special guests joining us in our endeavor to create something really cool in one day. You may have noticed that we didn't have an episode in March. That was because we had so many projects going on in parallel, and some of them were with our partners from Planet Studios who are joining us today. So we're super stoked about what's going to happen, because this is going to be the first time we're going to have another team joining us. So stay tuned and let's see what happens today. To take you on a quick tour of free office. Here we have our little studio, which we're going to use for the intro scene, as well as some potential interview situations. And here we'll arrive in the workshop and development area. We already see our busy bees preparing everything. Then for some leisure and fun, we have our chill area. You probably remember this from our last video, where we're gonna do the brainstorming.
Morning.
Good morning.
I slept very well.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. You excited?
Yes.
Hi, Debbie.
Fabio.
Welcome to our one-day challenge.
Thanks for having us.
You guys are our special guests today, so do you want to quickly introduce yourselves and tell a little bit about Planet Studios, what you do, how we got together, and why you guys are here?
Sure thing. So we are as well based in Hamburg. We are part of the Salesman Group called Planet Studios. We are a studio for special experiences and the next web, so everything web related. And we know each other because we've done some work together already. We've built the Uberverse together.
Also some trips.
Some trips. We've been to Portugal as well.
True.
So by now, we might already have had our anniversary by now. You guys came along the journey and helped us come up with this really, really beautiful project.
Brainstorming session is over and went on for quite some time. The idea that came out of it, I think, is pretty cool. So our goal for today is to create a user journey for a VR, AR, mixed reality pizza, frozen pizza experience with some surprises to come.
So currently, and I drew it in a pizza form because of any other shape is out today. So the first part of the experience is unpacking. So I am a user that is already in the mixed reality headset. I go to my freezer, I get it out, I put it on the table and I unpack the product. And we can do something there. So we have to sit down and figure out what is like the best and most effort here. Then there's this unfreezing waiting time. Maybe we find some easy ideas like watching a movie or something. And then there's the oven time, which is shorter but more intense. So this is currently where we have the game idea. And then obviously there is the eating experience and the one where we can just end the video or end the idea very nicely, right?
Now we need to think about the questions, how detailed, what kind of animation happens there. At this stage, because this is more or less the key thing that we're producing.
So is it a mini game, or is it information, or is it like immersive storytelling that comes within 10 minutes and then, it's not done, put it into the oven.
Okay.
So the concept in a nutshell is waiting sucks, but even the best frozen pizza that is supposed to be really, really fast without any waiting time needs two waiting times. First, when you preheat the oven, and second, when you bake the pizza. And what we do is we make this waiting time fun so that you really wait until these periods are over. And we do this with two little funny guys. One is called Pomo Piano, which is a pomatum. And he's always like, you gotta wait, you gotta wait, and I'll tell you why. And then there's Danger Doro, who is very hangry all the time and always wants to interrupt.
I'm working on the pizza stove because we couldn't find a good model and it's not that complicated, so I think I'll have it ready in an hour or something.
And this is what we're going to use for the middle part of the experience,
right? Yeah.
Okay, there is this technology and it is new and there's not much that we can take as an example, so there's a lot of free space to roam around and obviously it takes a lot of time to narrow yourself down to something where you're like, okay, I think that's the thing we're gonna build. I think we arrived at that space now, so we're in detail mode. Basics are set up, the first things are being built, but obviously exceeds the amount of time required that we usually take for these.
Yeah, I mean, we're done with the storyboard for the actual product and also for the little film that we're preparing here. And I think it looks good. We really have some nice concepts there. It's a good storyline. It's overarching from VR to AR and back. I think what we discovered today is that the Vision Pro is really a great tool supporting a story. Really an overarching story that comes from one end, begins maybe in a totally different space, then moves to AR, to VR, and back. And that you can really tell a whole story on the Vision Pro that has never really been done before.
So we have the oven, which we will experiment a little bit to see how can we blend the oven in as an AR mixed reality object with actual interaction. It's going to be tricky, but there are a lot of options there. Then we have Pomo, who is an interactable object that I can drag around and place on the desk or something, so it looks real. And then there is this window, who will simulate the pizza box that we can look through.
It's not that easy, and this is something we found out today, to develop concept for the Apple Vision Pro, because it's not that one VR thing or this one AR thing, it's a combination of all those touch points, and to develop like a storyline
that works across all of them.
And we actually dreamed quite big, right? Yeah. I mean, we were looking for the perfect user journey across a new device, which has so many outlets and so many touch points and so many implications. So
and no user journeys yet.
No, yeah, true. Yeah, yeah. And no templates to look at, right?
End of the day.
It was fun to have fun again. Quote.
No, it really, I think it's so much liberating to not really have a client briefing and like, this is what you need to do, but you can choose everything. It's really hard something to choose anything. So I think it's totally understandable that we were quite a bit lost in the beginning of all the opportunities we might be able to encounter. Still, I think we did good. It would have helped maybe to have two sessions from the very beginning, like one concept phase, as we did today.
Yeah, I think the factor that was quite different is that we didn't have a frame when we came into this. It was Vision Pro,
yeah.
But we found out Vision Pro actually covers so many bases. It's like, where do you even start? Because when we looked at VR development, we only had VR. It's okay, you're in this world, what do you do in this world? And when we do something for the metaverse, it's like, okay, there is this browser window and you have the avatar in the 3D world. Okay, that's what you do.
First of all, I like to say thank you.
Really?
For I mean, like, yeah. Really? Like, for like, I mean, like the for the ones that organized it, everything, and really just for like how everyone behaved today. It was like, you really, we all behaved. But I really felt it was an eye level co-working day, and that's what I really take out of this, that we can work on a super eye level together.
We're pretty much done with the debugging.
Okay, then.
No, thanks again to everyone. It was awesome.
You.
Yeah.
是的，宝宝。 Hey, you should not wait. Danger. No, you should not wait. You should not put the pizza into the oven.
Throw the pizza in the oven.
No, don't put it in the oven.
Oh, mi amor. Now I want hungry.